ESPN's ongoing docu-series following Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls dynasty became the network's highest-rated telecast since January's college football championship. This comes as the network struggles without live sporting events.
With the massive success of our Michael Jordan 10-part docu-series, ESPN has decided to expand The Last Dance to 142 parts. That's right. We combed through all the footage and decided to include everything. His shoes, his underwear, his sandwich.
I'm a big fan of the McRib. And during Jordan's heyday, they rechristened the sandwich the McJordan, but only in the Chicago area. So one time I have a layover at O'Hare and I go to the McDonald's and I took one bite. I went, wow, this man is the greatest basketball player of all time.
We even kept this interview.
I remember him. He played baseball for the Birmingham Barons. He also played basketball?
He did. Look.
That makes sense. He was pretty tall.
And what documentary would be complete without astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson?
Space Jam. I don't care how great an athlete you are, you still must obey the laws of gravity.
And when we run out of footage about the best player on the Chicago Bulls, tune into our series about the worst player on the Bulls. Denny Sinclair.
Michael, what's a three-letter word for automobile?
ESPN. Milking this thing for all it's worth.